Hey, went in there, buddy.
Alright, so I've got pictures tomorrow, so you guys, I'm sure it's giving me some singing lessons, so we'll see how that works. So. Don't think that'll be going well. So we had a suggestion yesterday and talked to Jose about it. We've added some presses and we need some tables. So we need tables for put together or fabricated. So we're gonna work on. Can you work on a list of what you need, Jimmy? And if you want to work with Jose, what you guys need also, so we can sort of get a stagger them out to make sure they don't come in once. And I'd also like to get with Rich to make sure there's something else, anything else we want to add to the new tables. You know, or other things that we see problems with the existing tables before we change the design. Okay? Right now, we have Kaizen events that we need to be signed up for that we got going, so we want to make sure that we get those all together, you know, get signed up and get involved with that. So we have one going on tonight, Israel again. We're good tonight at 10, so you don't need to come in. Okay? All right, so for the group in here, hey Nick, where's Nick? Where's the mic? Thank you, I'll bring it back. Where's Nick? Nick, I didn't know which order the pictures were and what was the order of improvement from before and after, so do you want to explain what we've got here?
This is how the gambit looks now. I just made one small improvement. It's a work in progress. You're going to have to go to the cabinet, grab the impact wrench and the impact sockets. The sockets would always fall out of the holder. It would just be set on the table and it would get all moved around. I just made a little small improvement, put them in one of our blue bins. There's a location for them all. Have one bin and you've got them, the impact wrench and the sockets all in one together.
So instead of like wasting motion to pick up two different things, go back and forth and drop it, now we have one spot, one thing to pick up. So very good. Excellent job. Thank you. Good job. All right. Sorry. All right, culture. It would be a mistake to assume Toyota has perfected developing a uniform culture even within a given operation. There are subcultures that form naturally in a plant. For example, the subculture of a plant floor managers is different from that of the human resource managers. Managers have a different subculture compared to production workers. Within production workers as a group, there is a subculture of union advocates that is different from that which is not disposed towards unionizing. Toyota works hard to develop a common culture across the company, even between the shop floor and the office. For example, human resource managers have typically worked in the factory as the shop floor managers. Human resource representatives, many of whom previously worked in production, are assigned to specific areas of the plant and are expected to spend the majority of their time in those areas of the plant to gauge the culture and develop team members. Spending the majority of their time in front of the computer, thereby isolating themselves from people who perform the firm's value-added work, is alien to the Toyota way. Achieving strong alignment among the varying levels of culture is a difficult process that has been one of the main challenges for Toyota as the company has expanded globally. It begins with selecting employees and partners, and then extends to maximizing every opportunity to teach and socialize a team member into the organizational way of thinking. It takes years and it is a career-long endeavor. Ultimately, the ability to absorb the company's culture lies in people's heads. It is how they think, act, and react to different circumstances. From a common American perspective, we might think of this negatively as brainwashing. From Toyota's perspective, this is absorbing the DNA in all team members. Okay? Just to give you an example of this, we were talking about some stuff happening and explaining what's going on. Terry and I were talking about different things going on taking some of the culture stuff that's going on. And Karen's first thing Karen says to me is, can I get out and work with people more? Can I get out with them? Can I work with people out here on the floor here? And can I work so she can understand what's going on? So Karen recognizes that, you know, to understand what everybody's doing here is Hanson. So it was a real value-added opportunity to talk to Karen about. So you'll see Karen out here coming up to make sure she's more involved and understands what you guys, everyone's going through from all departments. So, okay. We have a video here, and then we're, don't take off. Karen's got something to talk about.